My name is Clarence Cooper. I'm a United States District Court Judge for the Northern District of Georgia. I was appointed to the federal bench in Atlanta, Georgia by former President William Clinton in 1994. My journey to the federal bench has been challenging, extremely difficult, and has required a great deal of hard work and perseverance on my part. But I feel fortunate to have been able to represent the people of this city, state, and nation as a city judge, a county judge, a state court of appeals judge, and now a federal district court judge. And I've been on the federal bench for the last 20 years. My mother had instilled in me and my brother that we would go to college. Certain family members had preceded me and gone to Clark. So Clark was an easy decision for me to make coming out of high school. I wanted to go to Clark College. And I was able to get a partial scholarship, and I was able to work hard and cover those expenses that the scholarship didn't cover. I feel blessed to have been able to get a scholarship to go to Howard University School of Law. And after my first year of that, I transferred to help integrate the law school at Emory University. That was in 1965. There were four of us who integrated Emory University School of Law back then, and I was among the four. My most memorable moment at Clark College student occurred my sophomore year. I took a course in religion and philosophy from Dr. C. Eric Lincoln. At that time, Dr. Lincoln was writing a book on the black Muslims in America, and he invited to our classroom Malcolm X. At that time, Malcolm X was not widely known, but he invited him into our classroom, and Malcolm X gave a lecture to all of our students on being proud of our blackness and also the role that we as students could play in dismantling a segregated society. So I'm fond of telling people that I came to know Malcolm X before he became famous. I knew after my freshman year what it was I really wanted to do, that was to become a lawyer. And I then knew I had to take certain steps to become a lawyer. Never did I think remotely that I would become a judge. That came about during my first year in law school. I decided I wanted to be a federal judge. And I decided that if I wanted to be a federal judge, certain things had to take place in my life to get to that point. And that's why it's so important to set short and long-term goals. My long-term goal was to be a federal judge. What short-term goals should I take to bring that about? So I tell young people who aspire for greatness that one thing you should cling to and do, and I find these attributes common to all people who become great. One, be focused. Two, be determined. Three, be passionate. Four, be a hardworking individual. And five, be disciplined. And along the way, as you pursue greatness, you should set short and long-term goals. And I think that in of itself would enable you, hopefully one day, to achieve some degree of greatness.